appointed Deputy Chief Justice Raymond Zondo as chairperson of the commission as per the Public Protector's Remedial Action. Ray Bateman takes a look.
The Commission of Inquiry has been tasked with establishing the veracity of the allegation that former Deputy Minister of Finance Ntebisi Jonas and Faki Mentor were offered cabinet posts by the Guptas. It will also look at whether President Jacob Zuma played any role in these alleged offers to Jonas and Mentor. Whether information related to cabinet positions were disclosed to the Guptas will also be in the spotlight. Barry Bateman, Eyewitness News.
Tributes have continued to pour in for veteran actor Sandy Mokoena, commonly known for his role as Bra AD on ETV's Soapy Scandal. Mokoena was admitted to hospital yesterday evening and died in early hours this morning at the age of 68. He's been remembered by his colleagues as a generous man who was also a comedian of note. Members of trade union Nehau have gone on strike at Rhodes University after wage talks deadlocked. The union is demanding a 9% salary increase as well as changes to the salary grading of the lowest paid workers. Nehau says management is offering 6.8%. Spokesperson Tumishi Mahihaba.
We are negotiating with the certain caliber of management because they walked out of their reconvention on the 23rd, which was called by the chair of council. They walked out of that meeting where we were hoping we would find some line.
And former Zimbabwe First Lady Grace Mugabe's thesis has finally been made public 4 years after she was awarded a doctorate by the University of Zimbabwe. She was awarded the degree just months after she was first reported to be enrolled. May has raised suspicions that Grace Mugabe's PhD was forged.
Lewis, 21 wickets have fallen at the Wanderers and we're still in day two. That's how testing the scoring pitch has been. India all bowled out for 187 and managed to dismiss South Africa for 194 with a lead of just 7 runs. Hashim Mamluk top scoring was 61. India at the moment 31 for 1. The lead is 24 runs. Pakistan beat New Zealand by 48 runs to level the 3-match T20 series 1-1. North Africa beat Bangladesh by 10 wickets, bowling them out for just 82. Arsenal's through to the League Cup final after beating Chelsea 2-1 last night. A one game in the absolute premiership as AmaZulu and Bloem Celtic finished goalless. Over at the Australian Open, the perfect women's final has been set up with the top 2 seeds meeting in the championship match. Simona Halep will take on Caroline Wozniacki, while Marin Cilic is through to the men's final after beating Carl Edmund in straight sets. He'll likely play Roger Federer, who takes on 21-year-old Chung Hyung. We'll have to wait and see who will walk out victors there. Roger Federer says he doesn't know too much about his opponent.
It's been nearly 4 years since Federer lost to a player as low as Jong in a major. This is the first time meeting between them in a chasm.
Apologies for that soundbite, certainly not Roger Federer indeed. Craig Gabriel speaking to us live from Melbourne. Springbok Sevens captain Rob Phillips-Naiman will represent South Africa for the 50th time in World Rugby.